Good morning, students. Today we are going to I'm just sending you the video on the heat zones of the earth. And as I told you in my Zoom class, we are having the three zones on the earth, that is torrid zone, temperate zone, and frigid zone. Now let's see how it's happened. It is, the story begins right from the shape of the earth. You can just see the right from the poles, it is somewhat flattened, and once we see on from the equator, it is bulging. Now here we are having our sun. Now suppose the sun, due to this shape, the earth is being heated differently right from the middle portion, then the upper portion, then the most upper portion. Now the sun rays are coming directly. First of all, let me introduce to the all the things over here. Now on the middle one, we are having the equator, and this is the most torrid zone or the hottest zone of the world. So all those country which lies on the equator, all those countries are very very hot, and mostly almost the biggest deserts is being found in this region only. As the earth is round, we can just see it right from its back also. Now afterwards, once we move towards the north or to south, we are having the temperate zone. So this is your south temperate zone and north temperate zone. And the line which is in the northern hemisphere, this is known as Tropic of Cancer. This is your Tropic of Capricorn in the southern zone. And here in the south frigid zone, we are having Antarctic Circle, and over here we are having Arctic Circle. Now this is the too much surprise, both the poles are being fully iced cap rather than the other these two. So once we are talking about the torrid zone, so you can just see although the sun rays are coming directly, now this is your sun. The sun rays are coming directly to this region. So this portion receives the more heat, and that is why this is called torrid zone. And as I told you earlier also, this torrid zone is throughout the world, throughout the countries which lies on this torrid zone or on the equator are relatively quite heated rather than the your temperate zone and the south temperate zone and north temperate zone. Mostly all the Thar Desert, Sahara Desert, all are situated in this line. If we once move to the Tropic of Cancer in the northern portion, you can just see this is the green portion. This portion is known as temperate zone because right from here the sunlight, it starts traveling somewhat slanting. This portion is neither very hot, neither very cold. And this happens both in the northern zone and the southern zone, southern hemisphere. So, the same case with over here, the sunlight is somewhat slanting right from here, and you can just see it is totally slanting till over here. So this portion, the countries lies on this north and south temperate zone. They are neither hot, neither very cold. And if we take the northern zone, northern hemisphere, we can see the sunlight, it reaches in a very slanting way. So all this till in the northern portion and in the southern hemisphere, you can just see the light is reaching over here. We can't say the light is sunlight or the heat is not coming over there, but they are in very slanting way. And once they are slant, so the intensity of heat is very very less, and that is why we are having northern hemisphere and the southern hemisphere, it is totally iced, snow covered, that we are having the lot of glaciers over there. And this is in the southern zone, again it is known as Antarctica Circle, and in the northern zone we are having Arctic Circle. So in this we can see due to the shape, we are having the three type of heat zones. Again, I'm telling you, the middle one, the yellow portion, is your torrid zone, very hot zone, which is on equator. all your deserts are found over here. Once we talk about the green portion in the northern and the southern, it is known as temperate zone. So north temperate zone, south temperate zone, the countries lies over here. It's neither very cold, neither very hot. And once we reach to the top of the poles, that is North Pole and South Pole in the downwards, the North Pole and the South Pole is the freezing zone, because although the sun rays or the heat reaches over there, the sun rays are very slanting, and the intensity of heat of the sun is very, very less over there. And that is why both the poles are snow-capped and covered with snow throughout the year. Today it is till here only, and in the next video I will send you about the atmospheric pressure, how the atmospheric pressure and winds right from the earth its work.